So let us look at next problem, which is cost of convertible debentures. Again, one more time, I'm telling you, this is also a new problem. Previously, it was not there in study material. Previously, probably it is not there in Indian textbooks also. Now you might ask, how do you know? I am teaching this for the last 15 years and I have done foreign courses also, in ACCA exams both I have written and I taught also. So I have seen these kind of problems in ACCA textbooks earlier, in CMI USA and CPA textbooks also earlier they are there. But in Indian textbooks and in ICAI study materials, these kind of problems in intermediate were introduced new. So again, important. Now imagine if there is a convertible debenture. Convertible debentures are known as hybrid instruments. So one side of this instrument is a debenture, but actually it is potential equity share also. So tomorrow it can be equity share. In that very interesting case, how the cost of capital can be calculated? So look here, example, a company issued 10,000 15% convertible debentures of 100 each with a maturity period of 5 years. Okay, very good. At maturity, the debenture holders will have the option to convert the debentures into equity shares of the company in the ratio of 1:10. That means for every one debenture, they'll give 10 shares. For every one debenture, they'll give how many shares? 10 shares they'll give. Okay. The current market price of the equity is 12 rupees. And historically, the growth rate in the shares are 5% per annum. Okay, compute the cost of debenture assuming 35% tax rate. This is the question. Okay, now imagine there is a shareholder, there is a debenture holder. The debenture holder agreed or opted to convert this into equity. How many shares he'll get? For every one debenture, you'll get 10 shares. Okay, so take calculator, 10 shares. Now tell me, what is the value of this 10 shares into Pawan sir, 12 rupees? No. 12 rupees is today's value, 12 rupees. But the option can be exercised after 5 years, no? So today's share price is 12 rupees. What would be the probable price of this equity share after 5 years? So look here, what is the situation? Today the company's equity share is rupees 12. After 5 years, what would be the price of each equity share? Now the student will say, Pawan sir, IDK, I don't know. How come you say I don't know? ICAI will not give you marks if you say I don't know. So simple, they have given growth rate 5%, no? Shares will grow by 5%, no? So today it is 12, tomorrow how much? And I know that the growth rate is 5% and also I know that number of years is 5. Growth rate is 5% and also number of years is 5, correct? So can I calculate 12 into 1 plus 0.05 whole power 5 will be the future value of this share. Pawan sir, after 5 years, will the share price be equal to this calculation? May not be. That depends on so many market conditions. But how would I know? So today I am using time value of money to extrapolate, to forecast what probably could be. Because in the past tense, this share has grown by 5. So I am assuming maybe it will grow by 5 only. So take 12 into 1.05 into 1.05 into 1.05 into 1.05 into 1.05. So you got 15.32. This is the value of each share, but one debenture holder will get 10 shares. A person who's holding one debenture will get 10 shares. So 10 shares into 15.32 is 153.20. Now what is the conclusion of the story? Who are you? Debenture holder. How much you paid? 100 rupees. What did you buy? Convertible debenture. What is the life? 5 years. After 5 years, can you convert that into equity shares? Yes. One debenture into how many equity shares? 10. What is the current market price of share? 12. What is the growth rate? 5. What is the expected? What is the expected price per one share after 5 years with 5% growth rate? I have used present value into 1 plus interest whole power 5. So like that I have calculated and it is 150. It is 15.32 per share. You will get 10 shares. So one debenture holder will get 153.20 at the time of redemption. You understand? Now calculate cost of redeemable debt. Formula: interest into 1 minus tax rate plus redeemable value minus issue price divided by n, whole divided by redeemable value plus issue proceeds divided by 2 into 100. Pawan sir, everything is available in formula, but the redeemable value is not there, Pawan sir. Beta, we have calculated redeemable value. Today, if you buy one debenture, you will get 10 shares and the value of 10 shares is 153.20. So 15 into, why 15? Because they said it is 15% debenture, no? It is 15% debenture, no? So you will get 15 rupees interest into 1 minus 0.35 plus what is the redemption value? 153.2 minus what is the issue price? 100 divided by how many years? 5, whole divided by 153.20 plus 100 divided by 2, whole multiplied by 100. Okay, so calculate 15 into 0.65, that is 9.75, plus 153.2 minus 100 is 53.2 divided by 5 is equal to 10.64, whole divided by 153.2 plus 100 divided by 2 is equal to 126.6 into 100. So 9.75 plus 10.64 divided by 126.6 into 100 is equal to 16.11. This is 16.11. What is this? Cost of convertible debt. 16.1, correct. Very interesting calculation. Even in accounting also, accounting for hybrid instruments is always difficult. You are studying CA inter, so your life is easy. Come to CA final, then financial instruments will be a topic. Then obviously equity shares and debentures calculation is easy. This convertible hybrid instruments will be there, no? Where you have one right to convert that. That will be little advanced level. But still, I don't think this is advanced level. This is very easy. Now our Chintu will get it out. Sare. Oh, sare, I have got one doubt, sare. Why can't I consider year 0, 1 to 5, 5 cash flows? Today I am buying this with 100 rupees. Cash inflows, 15 into 0.65, 9.75 here. And 5th year I will get 153.20. Why can't I calculate IRR of this cash flow and say that is my KD? Exactly, this is another alternative. You can do like this also. You can do like this also. Already we have solved the last problem in this model only, no? So shall we do it like this again? So same model. Okay. Delete the ink. Okay, so this, I'm removing this. Rate 1, I take 15% because in the question they said 15, no? Rate 2, I take 20%. So my values also will change. This will change, this will change, this will change, this will change. Cash flows minus 100. Plus 9.75 plus 153.2. Okay, present value factor at 15%. So open your annuity table, go to present value annuity factor, and in that present value annuity factor, what is the rate we have taken? 15%. So for 15%, can I say present value annuity factor 3.3522? Here I will put 3.3522. Correct. Then at the end of 5th year present value, so we'll take 20% also here, 20% 2.9906, correct. Then go to present value table, 5th year at 15%, 0.4972, and what is the second one? At 20%, 0.4019. So first one is giving you plus 8.85, second one is giving you minus 9.27. So can I apply interpolation formula? Happily yes. So take 15 plus NPV at 15, 8.85 divided by 8.85 plus 9.27 into 5. First calculate denominator, 8.85 plus 9.27, that is equal to 18.12. So I am calculating 8.85 divided by 18.12, that came to 0.48, multiply with 5, that comes to 2.44, plus 15, that comes to 17.44. This is the cost of debt. Pawan sir, but when we applied first method, we got 16 point something. When we are applying second method, it is 17.44. Beta, they are two different models. So obviously, two different answers only will come. The answer of that model will never be equal to answer of this model. Process is different. No? Now, Pawan sir, which is the correct KD? Aray, listen. KE you calculated using 6 different models. Okay, dividend yield model, dividend growth model, discounted dividend discount model, then EPS model, EPS growth model, realized yield model, then capital asset pricing model. So do you think any two methods you apply, the answer will be same? No, but all of them are accepted. Like this, KD calculated using redemption formula, accepted. KD calculated using yield to maturity, accepted. They give two different answers, that's all. Now check what your beautiful institute is saying. 17.4 is correct answer. Yay! This is the answer. So what is this? This is, imagine in the question you are doing cost of convertible debentures with yield to maturity. So what is this? Cost of convertible debentures with yield to maturity. Little advanced problem, but not a difficult thing. Okay, once you understand the concept, it is cakewalk. Any doubts in this?